Hi, subbies. Thanks for tuning into the KG Lifestyle. Today, I'm here with a favorites video. I know I don't do these monthly, but I am trying to do better. So let's just go right into it. I have this box here of favorites, so I can't really say that they're my January, February, or March favorites, but we'll just say current favorites. Let's start with hair, because I know you guys all want to know what kind of hair products I've been loving lately. Moving to Dallas was a bit of a change hair-wise because there's so much more humidity here. So I've had to deal with that and experiment and figure out what works best. So far, I have found that using a little less leave-in and a lot more styler works for me. And I have returned after, I think it's been probably 2 years that I haven't used this product, but I have returned to my Olive Oil Eco Styler. It's super, super heavy. It evens out the crunch for me. Like if I lived in New Jersey or if I was still in Detroit, it would actually dry out my hair because it was so cold there that it wouldn't allow my hair to kind of soften up. But here, the humidity breaks down just enough where I have some definition for about 4 to 5 days and not too much crunch at all. So loving my Eco Styler again. Another recent hair favorite is from the Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil line. It's their hair lotion, their styling lotion. Really, really good. I use this straight out of the shower. And like I said, when I do my wash and go, I use a little bit of leave-in, and this is the leave-in that I've been loving lately. And then I definitely use a good size, you know, per section of this Eco Styler. I know I posted on Instagram what kind of, you know, Eco Stylers you guys loved or which ones were your favorites. And it was a tie between argan oil and olive oil. So let me know below if you've tried those two or if you've tried the original. Let me know below which one is your favorite, because I am curious about other Eco Stylers since I'm going to be using that for the summer. That's literally the only other hair product. Wow, I'm pretty simple these days. Other than those products, I use a little bit of coconut oil. So a couple of clothing items were sent to me by shabbyapple.com, and I really, really love them, like genuinely love them. This is a dress that they sent me. It's kind of hard to see, but I'll make sure to insert some clips. It's just a longer kind of summer dress, but it's made really, really well, and it scrunches up on the side, so it kind of hides any potential rolls or actual rolls that may exist. And I have worn this at least 3 times so far to work, so I genuinely love this dress. They also sent me a really, really cool skirt. Don't know where I'm gonna wear this yet, but I absolutely love this skirt. It's a tutu, and I love the color, and just the way it fits is really, really cute because it really accentuates your waistline, and you kind of tie it around. If you guys have ever worn like a lot of African skirts, they tie around in kind of two parts where they have an inner section and then an outer section. I don't know if that makes sense, but this tutu is really long. You guys know I'm 5'11", so it takes a lot of fabric to make a skirt that actually, you know, can fit my height, and they did, and I just absolutely love it. So for more information on these two clothing items, check out shabbyapple.com, and I'll have links below. So let's go into the next section, which will be body. So I love lotions, I love to smell good, and I have been loving this Bath and Body Works Pure Paradise, and it's an ultra shea body cream, and it says it's 24 hour moisture, which is what I need because I just feel like I need something super moisturizing. I just love having silky skin, so Pure Paradise is one of my favorite scents. I think they have a semi-annual sale, so it just smells divine. It really does give me the feeling that I'm in Pure Paradise. Another is actually from the latest Ipsy bag that I've got. It's the Gilchrist and Soames. I don't know if that's how you say this, but it's the body lotion that came in the last Ipsy bag, and it came like in a little tube, but it's a good amount. Like, I could take this and use it as my hand cream in my purse. So really, really love this lotion as well. I like light scents, so nothing is that I'm suggesting is a heavy musky scent at all. I'm totally on the other side of the spectrum where I love light, fluffy, floral kinds of scents. The rest of this box, let me show you this box. The rest of this box is makeup. Apparently, I'm getting a little bit more into makeup. You guys know I'm on a challenge. I'm trying to do glam this year, be a little more glamorous, and just put a little more thought into my look, even if it does take me a little longer to get ready with my busy schedule. So what I have been doing is experimenting with a couple of different foundations. So I've been experimenting with a couple of different foundations since my skin broke out recently with adult acne. Because of that, I've had to say to myself, if you want, you know, your skin to get better, you have to either lighten up on the makeup or use the correct makeup for your skin. And I've diagnosed my skin, or actually I did go to a dermatologist, and she said that I do have oily skin. So her recommendation was to stop using pretty much all products that contained oil. Thankfully, Bare Minerals was so generous and had sent me this complexion rescue kit. So this is the box that came from Bare Minerals, and this was the actual tinted hydrating gel cream. This has no oil, no parabens. This stuff is great, and it's SPF 30. So with this Texas heat, I'm gonna be pretty protected. This is chestnut, but they also sent me sienna. So I have both chestnut and sienna because I really wasn't sure which color would match my skin. And what I actually do is mix these two together to use. The kit also came with a smoothing face brush, and I love this brush. I use this brush every day, even if I'm not using this foundation, but I love the way it applies to my skin. Using this brush has really helped because before I was using my hands. Now, the coverage for the Complexion Rescue, it's not supposed to be heavy, but I had all these breakouts and I had scars. So I actually did venture out to a full coverage foundation and settled on a dermatologist's suggestion, which was Ready Set Gorgeous. So this is from CoverGirl, and I've never used any drugstore foundations ever. Like, ever in life have I ever used any drugstore foundations. I've always used MAC or just no foundation at all, to be honest with you. Just in the last maybe 3 to 5 years, I've been wearing makeup, so this was a venture for me. The colors are kind of hard to find. So my shade is 315, and if you go to Walgreens, or if you go to CVS, or if you go to Rite Aid, you are not going to find 315. You're gonna see 310 and then 320. It's like they don't think that brown people come in different shades. I don't get it. So you have to go to Target. So this dries really, really well. This really helps my skin breathe. And again, it's full coverage. In addition to the Ready Set liquid foundation, I got the compact, which is also in 315. It's really, really light as well, and it sets my foundation well. I put those two on every day because I just love the way my skin feels. Like midday, I don't feel like I'm oily at all, or I never touch up my foundation. So for me, this works really well. Like, as I go throughout my day and I'm going from meeting to meeting, and then I come home and I'm doing all the things I do here in my office, I don't have to worry about getting super oily or the makeup just completely melting off my face, even with the, you know, humidity so far in Dallas. So highly recommend this. So you guys have been commenting a lot on Instagram and on my last video, the braided Bantu knot out, about my makeup and the eyeshadow. And I really have, like I said, been trying to do the glam look. Bare Minerals also sent me this little palette, and it's so cute. Is this not the cutest thing? It's a little gold palette, And it does come with a little brush. As you can see, the plastic is still on it because I still use my hands to apply my eyeshadow. So I'll use a little primer, but all those looks that you guys see recently, like in the last month or so, have been from this palette. And I love these colors. They're light, yet they're pigmented. Like, you can really see that I've got some kind of blended colors going on rather than it kind of just being lost on my eyelid. The Bare Minerals Ready Eyeshadow 8.0. So highly recommend this little palette if you're looking for like some neutrals. It comes with all the power neutrals is what it says. Another favorite, because I, like I said, I'm trying to do a little better. I kind of try to just institute little things at once. So I don't have time to sit down and play with my makeup all the time. So instead of doing that, I'll just try one thing here, one thing here. I have a whole bunch of bronzers. I have a whole bunch of palettes that I can use, but because I'm just trying to do small things with the limited time that I have been loving this Shea Moisture Illuminating Powder. So I believe this powder is actually supposed to be a setting powder, but it's obviously too dark for my skin. What I use it for is to contour right here in my, the hollows of my cheeks. So right here and right here, and then on my temples. That's pretty much it. I literally take this out and I've added this to my routine. It takes about 3 seconds to just add that little bit in the hollows of my cheeks, my temples, and then I drop the brush because I'm probably already late to work. A couple of lip liners that I've been loving. I've always loved this. This is Cork, but I have found that I've picked it up again because I love the nude lip, kind of like the one I have on now. So I use Cork as my lip liner, and when I do, I always use Modesty by MAC. And then I put a gloss on it and I just love that look. But I have been trying to experiment with other colors, and I picked up this CoverGirl Lip Perfection in Sophisticated. And it's like a deep purple, it's a burgundy color, and it's really, really, really pretty. I put it with a lot of my pinks and it just makes the colors pop even more. I wore this actually in LA. So if you saw my vlog from LA, this is what I was wearing the whole time, even when I was taping and filming with all of the rest of the Maker Girls. All information about everything that I've mentioned here will be below. Make sure to subscribe, follow me on Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat at The KG Lifestyle, and check out my blog, thekglifestyle.com. And I will see you all later. Peace and blessings. Bye.
This is my Tesla. I'm gonna get a job at Tesla to pay for